Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In today's session, let's cover one of the most important topic, which is tkinter, which is used in graphical user interfaces in Python programming language. So friends, today let's look into tkinter. So what is tkinter? Python provides various options to create graphical user interfaces. It is also called GUI. So Python provides various options to create graphical user interface. Some of the important options which Python provides for creating graphical user interfaces are Kiwi, tkinter, PyQt, and then PySci. So these are the four graphical user interface frameworks which are most popular these days. And among them, tkinter is one of the commonly used graphical user interface in Python programming language. So today let's discuss about tkinter. Is the most commonly used GUI frameworks is most commonly used GUI frameworks for creating or developing GUI applications . Okay, tkinter is the most commonly used GUI framework which is used for developing GUI applications. We can create GUI applications using tkinter in a very easy and in an easy manner. So tkinter is nothing but a standard library available in Python programming library. In Python programming language. So friends, Python provides various options to create GUI applications. The four important frameworks are Kiwi, tkinter, PyQt, PySci. Today let's discuss about tkinter, which is the most commonly used GUI frameworks for developing GUI interfaces GUI applications. It is nothing but a standard library which is available in Python. So with the help of tkinter, we can easily develop GUI graphical user interface for desktop applications. And now let's see how we can create a GUI app. How to create a GUI application. So there are four steps which we have to remember for creating a GUI application in tkinter. The first one is we have to import tkinter module. Firstly, we have to import the tkinter module. The second step is to create a main window. Thirdly, we have to add and desired widgets. On to the main window. And fourthly, we have to call a main event loop to capture the processing on the screen. So these are the four steps we have to remember while creating a GUI application. The first one is we have to import the TK Inter module. Secondly, we have to create a main window. Thirdly, we have to add the desired widgets on the main window, whatever we have created in step 2. For the step 3, we can add the desired widgets on the main window. Then we have to call a main event loop, which goes on in an infinite loop and it will capture all the processing happening on the screen. So friends, these are the four things which we have to remember for creating a GUI application using TK Inter. And what are the different widgets which are available in TK Inter? Let's have a brief on those things. The different widgets in TK Inter. So the different widgets are label. There are around 20 widgets in TK Inter. So let's name a few of them. Next is button. All these are widgets in TK Inter. The third one is entry. Fourth one is label frame. Fifth one is frame. Sixth one is menu. Seventh is menu buttons. Eighth is text. Ninth is canvas. Tenth is message. 11th is message box. 12th is scale. 13th is scroll bar. 14th is check buttons. 15th is radio buttons. 16th is top level. 17th is spin box. 18th is pan window. 19th is list box. So friends, these are the various widgets which are available in TK Inter. So based on our requirement, we can add these widgets on the main window and create graphical user interfaces. First one is label, button widget, entry widget, label frame widget, frame widget, menu widget, menu buttons widget, text widget, canvas widget, message widget, message box widget, scale widget, scroll bar widget, check button widget, radio button widget, top level widget, spin box widget. It is spin box. Spin box widget, pan window widget, and list box widget. So these are the various widgets which are available in TK Inter for creating graphical user interface. It is very easy to learn these widgets and see how we can place it on the main window. So today we have just mentioned the widgets. In the coming sessions, let's look into each of the widgets in detail. So friends, hope so it is clear for you. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.